guys, thanks for watching. Welcome to my channel, Saumya's Bookstation. I'm Saumya, and on this channel, I spread all the book love that I can. If you like my videos, please like and share them and subscribe to my channel. And also, do not forget to press the bell icon so that every time I post a video, you get notified. So it has been some time since I last uploaded a video. Well, I was not able to for the fact that just life happens sometimes and you're not able to do things that you love. But now I'm back to making videos and I'll try to be more regular than I was in the month of June because, well, I really miss making more videos and that's what I'm going to do in July. I'm going to talk about the books that I read in the month of June 2018. I read 8 books in the month of June, which I think is a decentish kind of a number because, well, it could have been lesser. It's still more than what I read in May. I think I read 7 books in May. So I read 1 book extra, so that is definitely something to be happy about. Let's get into the video where I'll tell you about the books that I read in the month of June. The first book is Third Girl by Agatha Christie. So a young girl goes up to Poirot and tells him that she may have committed a murder, but she does not offer any further information and she walks out on him. So Poirot obviously starts thinking that there is something wrong and he sets about to find out the answers to the questions that are arising in his mind. So this is obviously a murder mystery. I did not love this book that much, to be honest. I mean, initially this was interesting because obviously it's a murder mystery, so there is that air of suspense that starts building up in the beginning of such stories. Then it kind of got confusing, then it got interesting. And one more problem that I had with this book was that the plot kind of started stretching as I was reading it. I mean, it got boring in between and then towards the end it's kind of picked up. But that is something that I don't enjoy in a murder mystery. I mean, my idea of a good murder mystery is something that should be interesting from the start to finish. So I was kind of disappointed with this book, but I do like how Agatha Christie writes and how she explains what's going on. But that was not enough for me to love this book. The next book is The Illicit Happiness of Other People by Manu Joseph. So first things first, I am probably going to pronounce the names of the characters in the story wrong because I have not heard these names before, so I don't know how to say them. So I'm apologizing in advance. A 17-year-old boy, Uni Chako, did something really terrible and nobody really knows why he did what he did. So one day, Uni's father, Usep Chako, discovers a comic strip drawn by Unni because Unni was an artist, and Usep kind of finds out that the clue to what Unni did might lie in that comic strip, so he starts investigating. Now Usep Chako is not aware that while he's investigating, his wife is actually plotting to kill him because she's fed up of him. So this is a very different, unusual kind of a story. When I had read the synopsis, I was not able to make out what the story was actually going to offer, and I'm so glad I wasn't able to because I was in for a lot of surprises. I have really started enjoying Manu Joseph's writing. He's actually very close to becoming one of my favorite authors. He has written 3 books so far. I've read 2 out of them and I've enjoyed both books by him. The last book that I read by him was Miss Leela, Armed and Dangerous, and since I had really liked that book, I was expecting a lot from this book and I'm so happy that I was not disappointed. The language of this book is to the point, the observations are sharp, the humor is inappropriate, and that is something that really sets this book apart from the others that I've read, and I had an amazing experience reading this book. The next book is Some Assembly Required, The Not-So-Secret Life of a Transgender Teen by Aaron Andrews. So this is a non-fiction book. It's basically a memoir of Aaron Andrews, who's a transgender boy who was born as a girl named Emerald. But then Emerald realized very early on in her life that her mind and her body do not really match, and mentally and emotionally she's a boy but she's actually trapped in a girl's body. So basically in this book, Aaron Andrews has very, very honestly laid bare his life from the time when he was a girl to the time when he transitioned into a guy, and the challenges that he faced, the challenges that were emotional, physical, biological, and how he emerged triumphant out of it. My experience while reading this book was absolutely marvelous. I think this is a very eye-opening book and also very, very insightful. I did not expect that I would love this book so much that I ended up buying this book because it was a very, very different kind of an experience for me reading this book, and it was different in a way that I loved. The next book is The Curious Incident of the Dog in the Nighttime by Mark Haden. So this is a story about a 15-year-old boy named Christopher who has Asperger's syndrome, which is a form of autism. Now, Christopher is somebody who has a very limited understanding of human emotions, but he is very much into maths and he loves making lists. Basically, he is into things that he's able to understand. So in this story, Christopher finds out that his neighbor's dog has been murdered. Now, Christopher has to find out who killed his neighbor's dog, so he sets out to investigate, and that turns into quite an adventure for him. This is one of the books that I had quite a few expectations from because I've heard great things about this book from people around me. So, naturally, I was expecting to love this book, but the thing is that I did not love this book. Well, I did not hate this book. The good thing about this book is that I love the writing style. It's very well written. The story unfolds with a humor that is very raw, and also sometimes the story is very, very sad. But the thing that I did not like about this book was the story itself. I mean, parts of it were enjoyable. Overall, I was not really satisfied with how the story kind of ended. For me, the ending of the story is kind of incomplete. I don't know, I just wanted something more to happen. And towards the end of the book, my reaction was that, was that it? Was this the story? Well, I'm not quite happy with how it ended. The next book is Are Trees Still Growing There by Ruskin Bond. It is a collection of short stories from Ruskin Bond's childhood, his adult life. And each and every story is autobiographical in nature because it has been told in first person. Now, some of the incidents, I think they really took place. Some of them are imagined. So, in these stories, we get to meet Ruskin Bond's family members. We get to read about his relationship with his father, his mother, his grandparents. And then we also get to read about his encounters with people who came in his life for a brief period of time but whom he did not quite forget. So this book has a lot of simplicity both in terms of the language and in terms of the way the stories take place and the way events unfold. It's a very, very easy, breezy, relaxed kind of a read. Now this is the kind of book where I do not mind slow-paced stories because these are the kind of books that you just pick up to just enjoy on a lazy day. The next book is Adi Parva Churning of the Ocean by Amruta Patil. So this is a graphic novel and this is a retelling from the events of the Mahabharata until the time Kauravs and Pandavs were born, and the narrator of the story is Ganga. Now the word that has been used in the story is Sutradhar, which means a storyteller. So Ganga is the Sutradhar and she tells you the entire story of how this world came into being right from the beginning up till the point Kauravs and Pandavs were born. So this is obviously a retelling, and I am just going to say that initially it kind of begins at a pace that is sort of slow, but then it starts gaining the pace and you start getting more and more into this book as you turn the pages. I think it's a very, very powerful and a beautiful retelling. The illustrations in this book are absolutely breathtaking. I was so in love with all the illustrations and the artwork because they really added to the appeal of the story, because in case of a graphic novel, how the artwork is really makes a difference to how the story looks. This book has made some really strong points. Like, one of the things that I really liked about this book is that it really stressed on the point that it is really the essence of the story that matters. But this is not really a standalone graphic novel. This is a part of a duology. The second book in the duology is called Soptic. The next book is The Mermaid and Mrs. Hancock by Imogen Hermes Scover. So Jonah Hancock is a merchant who sends around his ships to conduct business. So one day one of his captain returns and informs him that he has sold Jonah Hancock's ship for a mermaid. Now this piece of information spreads like a wildfire, and soon Jonah Hancock finds his fortunes turning only for the better. And so he meets Angelica Neal, who is a courtesan. She's extremely beautiful and she's a very, very desirable woman. Their lives kind of come together and the mermaid also plays a role. My experience reading this book was absolutely magical and enchanting. I loved every bit of this book. This story has so many things going on in it. It has covered so many aspects of how a human being behaves. There is ambition, there is greed. Racism has been touched upon in this book. How women get treated generally has also been talked about in this book. There is love in this book, and there is familial relationships and familial obligations that have been talked about in this book. This book is extremely enjoyable. I mean, I was going through a reading slump, and this is not that thin a book. It's kind of long for a person who's going through a reading slump. It's around 500 pages long, but not once did I put this book down. I finished this book completely. I did not break my flow even once despite my reading slump. It's a great book. It's a marvelous reading experience that this book gives you. The next book is The Old Man and the Sea by Ernest Hemingway. So this is a story about an old fisherman named Santiago who has gone without getting any fish for over 80 days, and people have started calling him unlucky. And Santiago is a person who is full of optimism. He's very, very positive. He doesn't give up. Stories about the challenges that human beings face and how life is never easy, but you cannot really give up. Giving up is not an option. I found it to be an extremely slow read. And because of that, I did not really have that good of an experience with this book as I would have liked. Now, the reason for that might be the fact that I was in a reading slump. So, a slow read does not really sit well with the reader while he or she is in a reading slump. So, I think that also played a part. I'm just going to go ahead and say that this book has actually captured the essence of the struggles that human beings face in their lives. If you want to read this book, you should definitely go for it. It's just a novella after all, but I am not really going to go out of my way to recommend it. So that was my June wrap-up, guys. Let me know in the comment section your own June wrap-up. Which books did you read and how is your reading progress going? I would love to hear from you guys. That was it for today's video. The links to my social media are in the description box. I'll be back with my next video super soon. Bye-bye.